Then since market momentum of FXS is pretty strong, you know, because we're going to target on, you know, Shanghai upgrade on Ethereum. Then after this, I think, you know, these liquid staking player on the Ethereum platform experienced a pretty, you know, strong, you know, tipping growth point here. Then based on this, probably, you know, 0.618 might happen here, because we're going to also see pretty strong support line on this price level here. That's why pretty strong. Okay. Hi, hello, I'm mr.masa. So today's review item, Brew Beer, price analysis, February 15th for Looks, DBT, FXS, and Rido. Okay, so let's start. Then this is my portfolio performance as of now. So total return since March 2019 is 680%. Then if you're interested, much more detailed information about portfolio allocations and also my real-time buy and selling signal for every single crypto assets, including ICO, idea on DeFi, please think about to join my premium membership program real time by adding selling signal. The major purpose of this membership program to help to reach your crypto set performance to my level here. Then for more detail, please check out my video. Here's my video link. Okay. Then let's stop here. Looks. So Looks USDT daily chart. Okay. The last week, that was amazing for the Looks, because we're gonna see, you know, they're gonna almost hit the upper limits based on the Fibonacci retracements. So price is around 0.3739, but they're gonna hit the higher than this one number here. This was amazing, right? Then, but now, you know, market itself is starting to be bearish trend. So we have to prepare for the, you know, price question moments here. Then critical, you know, price line for the Looks here is probably this, you know, orange, you know, blue trend line here. Okay, if they can maintain this line here, this summer we're gonna see much, you know, stronger bullish line. That's what I'm thinking about, okay? Then next one, DVT, DeFryzen. So, DeFryzen is also a pretty good move here. We're gonna see the bridge breakout against, you know, this EMS 75. That was really great. But still, we have to prepare the, you know, bearish trend from here, okay? Then next one, FXS. So, FXS USDT daily chart basis. So, FXS also hit the pretty strong number here. They're gonna, you know, hit also the peak level on a Fibonacci based one, 0.236. The price is around at the 13.762. As you can see, this is amazing work. Then, but now we have to prepare, you know, bearish trend, right? Then, correct my price targets around 618 to 0.5 on a Fibonacci retrace based one. Price target is around $10 to $8.9. Okay. Then, since market momentum of FXS is pretty strong, you know, because we're going to target on, you know, Shanghai upgrade on the Ethereum. Then after this, I think, you know, these liquid staking player on the Ethereum platform experienced a pretty, you know, strong, you know, tipping growth point here. Then based on this, probably, you know, 0.618 might happen here, because we're gonna also see pretty strong support line on this price level here. That's why it's pretty strong. Okay. Then next one, Rido. Then Rido compared with FXS, it's not that quite strong, because they cannot hit the, you know, peakest level based on, like, in, you know, Fibonacci returns based one. But still it's bullish. Still it's bullish. Okay, then from here we have to prepare price questions. My target is from 1.5 to 1.8. That's level, right? Then next one, DeFi yield markets. So yield market TVL updates. Comics Finance plus 1.35%. TVL hit 4.21 billion. Okay? The Constellator still remain number 9. 7th exchange minus 1.67. TVL is 64.26. Okay. Then those number tend to be bearish from next week. That's what I'm thinking about. Okay. The same as yield market TVL updates too. Yan Finance this week's minus 1.32. TVL is 448.74 millions. Not so big change here, but tend to be bearish from next week. Then next one, DeFi insurance. So big news here, almost no change. Then hacked project weekly updates. We're gonna experience a serious hack last week, unfortunately. So Midas Capital, January 17th on Polygon hit the minus 66 million, not so big. Then Orion, February 2nd, they're gonna hit 3 million on Binance Smart Chain, not so big, but problem here, Bonk DAO, February 1st, hit the minus 120 million. It's huge. The next one, Decentralized IoT. So, feature of POS mining as of February 12th, Helium network, price 0.06, Ethereum beacon, 0.8%. It's good. Then there's a B2C, B2B dApps. Then NFT collectible ranking, sales volume, 7-day change. No big news here at this moment, okay? Then top 15 game. First player, Axie Infinity, as always. NFT volume level is around 30 million. It's pretty big. Then next one, Otor, 4.2 million on Binance Chain. Go and Chain, Ethereum and Immutable X, 3.77 million. DeFi Kingdom, 3.25 million. Sandbox, 2.2 million. Okay. Then little key news. So the top 10 gaming token had hit the 102% average price increase in January. As you can see here, how the game category is really, really hot in the Web3 season. Especially, you know, this summer, also, you know, BTC post halving moment is kind of starting from April 2024. Game title is one of the big topics for us. Okay, that's why I'm also seriously investing in a lot of game title. But probably leading player of these third generation NFT game after Axie Infinity are not these player. I don't think, you know, leading player is not come up from here. We're gonna have the new player. That's what I'm focused on. Okay. Then next one, top 15 collectibles. So CryptoPunk, 7 days NFT volume level is around 30 million. Amazing. Then NFT top shots, number 4, almost 1 million. And NFT all day, number 6, 430K. And NFT strike, number 12, is 31K. Okay. Then NFT marketplace, Uniswap still the king, amazing. Almost 1 billion volume level on the 7-day change. The next player is Buller. Currently, they're working on to launch their token on February 14th, okay? Then next one, social, top 15. Hooked, number one, active user size is 200K. Galaxy, second player, their active user base is 120K. Lens Protocol, 10K, and Cyber Connect, around 6.5K. Then about the Cyber Connect. Actually, I have a pretty big expectation for this potential here because look at this one. So for example, this is a tweet from CZ Binance. LinkedIn has 7,000 profile with a Binance employee of which only 50 or so are the real. It's a huge problem, right? We have a lot of fake account on LinkedIn. We have to be very, very seriously careful on this. Then the Cyber Connect is working on to solve this problem here because of the blockchain verifications. Then, you know, social graph with the authentic provenance, any kind of verification process about, you know, your identity, which is also related to digital identity, is really, really important. That is why, you know, I already get, you know, invitation code of the Cyber Connect. Then I already opened my page. This is what I want. I love this product. Okay. Then there's some top 15 others. ENS, top 7th, no big change here. Then ENS, monthly registration number, the February number is just static, no big change here, okay? Then here's kind of last slide. So what's the key mindset at the HODLer? So most people believe that the upper side scenario, smooth scenario, but the reality of HODL is bottom side scenario, okay? So the one of the key points, why don't you understand here that if you want to gain bigger investment return in a Web3 asset investment, be patient, okay? Then here's the result of HODL. So I do think that the HODL is best for the retail investor to minimize the risk and maximize the return because investment in Web3 assets, just like investment in early days of Google and Facebook. Then once we can look at the legendary angel investor attractions such as Longconway, Peter Thiel, Riedelman, all the time, they can take the simple investment approach. It's a long-term investment. Then here's the Bitcoin case, and the longest hold of Bitcoin also maximize the investment return. In this case, plus 220%, much larger number than other short-term one here. Then I'm gonna also basically take the long-term investment approach. So I'm gonna also recommend you guys to take the same approach too. Okay. All right, so that is all this time. So I'm gonna make this video for educational purpose. I'm not gonna guarantee any kind of certain level investment outcome with this video or any video that I make. But I truly hope that my video will partly help you guys understand about high potential about crypto and motor space. So So I'm gonna make a lot of this video crypto for this space. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Bye bye.